Imagine how things go when people become Muslims. طيب. Not only that. Another thing. When the Prophet ﷺ was born, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, the nurses, the ones who nurse, they didn't want to take him. Because why? The nurses at that time, they figured they want to take someone who's going to be something. And someone who doesn't have a father, almost guaranteed not to be anything. Because he doesn't have a father. Who's going to, if I nurse him, I'm not going to get any benefits. No benefit package. And Halima, radiallahu anha, according to most of the narrations, we don't want to get into the differences of narrations right now, but says, I looked and there was nothing, all the babies were taken. And I looked and I took that baby. And of course, you know all these things, we'll talk about it some other time, what happened. But there's a point here to be made. That the Prophet ﷺ was an orphan. Did not have a father. You know, because the tradition at that time, that's why, that's among the reasons why. The tradition at that time is that people say, my father, my father. And the Prophet ﷺ was an orphan also among the reasons, so he doesn't say, my father, he say, my Lord, Allah, Allah. It's a little bit step ahead. What happens in the life of the Prophet ﷺ when he said, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشْرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. We're coming back to the ayah, قُلْ كُمْ يَدُوا اسْتَغْفِرُوا. الحمد لله كما ينبغي لجلاله وكماله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى. Two journeys the Prophet ﷺ took that are very prominent in his life. A journey of al-Isra wal-Mi'raj and the journey of Hijra. Isra wal-Mi'raj and Hijra. Of course, you all know what happened in the Hijra. The migration. We talked about it, I think, 2 Jumu'ahs ago, or 3 Jumu'ahs ago, I don't remember. But we talked about the Hijra of the Prophet ﷺ and how was the trick and how it was made and the plan and all these things. And the Prophet ﷺ takes his Sahabi, the biggest Sahabi and the best of the Sahaba, radiallahu anhu, Abu Bakr Siddiq, takes him along with him and goes to Hijra. And you know how many dangers they get and they face. And death is almost there. Hatta Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu says, Ya Rasulullah, if someone looks at their feet, they will see us. And the Prophet says, Ya Abu Bakr, two, but Allah is our third. It's two, but Allah is third. And then they go on and they go on, and the Prophet walks days and nights, for days and nights through the desert till his feet swell and they bleed, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the people are following him, and no food, and the conditions, a very hardship journey full of hardships. From its beginning till its end, exposed to death so many times, until he reaches Medina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's one journey. And now this journey takes, what, 5 hours by car. Another journey the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took is al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. From Mecca, not to Medina, to Jerusalem. And from Jerusalem, not to Mars. Which take how many months did it take him to go to Mars? A few months? Seven. Okay. So, from that, to As-Samawat al-A'la ila Sidrat al-Muntaha. Within how, days, seconds, and minutes. Went from seconds to minutes, and Buraq came. Took him on the Buraq from Mecca all the way to Jerusalem within a split second. I don't think this is weird or this is unbelievable or this is like fairy tales. Because right now you have rockets that pass continents within minutes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of everything. So you have that went from Mecca to Al-Qudus mubasharatan in a few minutes, seconds, prayed with the prophets and then went through that space travel, that light years. Light years, who is the creator of light years? Allah. Went all the way through all the heavens. First, second, third, fifth, all the way. Sidrat al-Muntaha. And came back. Round trip ticket. And here, in this journey, in this trip, we don't see hardships. We don't see feet swelling. We don't see bleeding. Even though this is a much longer trip. You see? Why? Let's go back to the ayah, the first ayah we started with. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ. I am human like you. In the hijrah, in the migration, I am a human like you. So I have to go through these hardships. Even my feet have to swell. I have to walk. I have to sustain all these dangers. And I have to keep going till I get my goal. So you can follow me because in this sense I am a human like you. But no one is asking any Muslim to go do Isra and Mi'raj. Everybody is asking you to do Hijrah. But Hijrah is not only physical Hijrah. We said that yesterday, last time. We said, right? Psychological Hijrah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You do Hijrah to Allah with your heart. No one is asking you. You will sustain in the case, in the course of da'wah, you will sustain so many problems and many people will stand against you. And everyone who knows and who doesn't know will make himself a knowledgeable scholar. And everybody will start calling you names. This is normal. This is known. And there's all over the place. And if you want to throw a stone at everyone that says something, then the stone will cost money. Because everybody starts thinking. What? You have to sustain these hardships and go on. And knowing that the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the thing that you have to hold on to. Why? Because the second half of the ayah, إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيْهِ. Everything I say is wahi. It's not from me. If you try to make up a sunnah other than my sunnah, thinking that I am only a human being like you, then you're mistaken, because I am a human being like you in that sense, but I have wahi that you don't have, therefore my sunnah is the perfect sunnah and this is the complete sunnah. And therefore, if you don't follow my sunnah, then you're deviating. You see? Because many people, they say, we do our sunnah, we do our thing, and we replace the sunnah. You tell people, Rasulullah ﷺ said this. He says, no, I think it should be this way. Allah says this. He says, my teacher told me he has a tape. I believe what he said. Allah says, you have to verify. تبينوا. No, he says, no, I'm sorry. Where's the loyalty? To the sunnah of Rasulullah or to my teacher? Who's going to take you into Jannah? Following you. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, among their basic simple beliefs, dear brothers and sisters, that we don't do blind imitation to anybody, regardless who that person is. We only follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, his authentic sunnah and the book of Allah jalla wa ala. Nas sarih sahih. أسوة حسنة لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. Why? Because yet he is a human being صلى الله عليه وآله, but يوحى إليه. Therefore, you know what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in the Quran? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. The ayah means, telling the Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, اعلموا means know, acquire knowledge, that among you is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know what acquire knowledge means? I'lam means you have to acquire knowledge. You have to spend time to get knowledge. Just like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Did not say, Allah did not say, فَقُلْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Did not say لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Did not say mention لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Said فَعْلَمْ mean acquire knowledge. No. And that means acquiring knowledge. That means spending time to know لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. The same thing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. You have to have knowledge to understand who the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is. So you can see his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But this is absent. Many times, it's absent from our lives. Because my word matters than his word. It doesn't matter what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. أعوذ بالله. It's time for us to adjust our priorities and see if our priorities are according to the book and sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we see the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All these things that, and all these hardships that he sustained and suffered. The kind of people he had to deal with. And we take from him lessons on how far can we go and where can we go. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم بارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد صلاة ترضيك وترضيه وترضى بها عنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وأعلي يا مولانا كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إليه، ومن أراد بهم غير ذلك فاجعل دائرة السوء عليه. اللهم رد المسلمين إلى دينك ردا جميلا. اللهم آتي أنفسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم أحينا على السنة المحمدية وأمتنا على السنة المحمدية، واجعلنا من أهل السنة المحمدية، واحشرنا مع أهل السنة المحمدية. اللهم اشف مرضانا وعاف مبتلانا، فك اللهم أسرانا وارحم موتانا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولآبائنا ولمشايخنا ولمن له حق علينا ولمن على الخير أعاننا ولمن عن الشر أبعدنا ولمن أوصانا بالدعاء. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وآله، وأقم الصلاة.